In this lab, we will see how you can allocate a floating IP for your project, and then also we'll see how you can create various security rules, like suppose you want to allow only SSH or HTTP traffic, how you can do that. That we'll see, and both will be trying, and also we'll be seeing how you can create a key pair, SSH key pair, for your Linux instances to get access. So this key pair you can use to access your instances. So we'll see how you can do that. So we'll use both the methodologies. One will be via Web Horizon and another one will be via CLI client for our OpenStack. So for doing that, first let's log in as a user one and let's see how you can do that. So let's log in as user one first. So once you log in as user one, you go to compute and then you come to access and security. So in that access, so here you can see I have two floating IPs to use. So still now I didn't use anything. So for doing that, first we'll be going to the floating IP. So this floating IP will be used to communicate with the external network. So this is like our gateway IP address. So as you can see, I don't have any floating IP created for user one for project one. So let's click on allocate IP to project. So let's wait for it. So this IP will be allocating from public network. So if you remember, we have created that public network to communicate with the outside world. So when you go for a floating IP, so that will be your public IP for your project. So obviously that IP will be coming from the public network, not from your private network. So here we are selecting the public, and if you see, we have total two quota available for floating IPs, and till now we didn't even use anything. So it is both twos are available, so it will give you that quota usage also. So let's click on allocate IP. So it will allocate a floating IP to our project one. So let's wait for it to get completed. So as you can see, is allocated a floating IP 192.168.0.2. So now we will go to the security group to create a security policy to allow SSH and HTTP traffic. So for doing that, let's create the security policy. So click on create security group, and here you let's give it as a sec one description. Let's policy for SSH and HTTP. So let's put that policy. So you click on create security group. So here one thing you need to remember, that is just creating a security policy, you're just giving the name and description. Still now we didn't give any rules for our security policy. So you can see sec one is been created. So here if you click on that, so you have the option called manage rules. So click on manage rules. So this will help us to assign the policy. So you can see as of now it doesn't have any specific rule added. So you click on add rule. So here you put rule type is, let's put for HTTP. So we are not giving any specific address range. So if you want to have it like security group also, you can do remote from particular security group only can connect, or if you want to have like anyone can connect, you give CID as a 0000 and 0. So it will be like for all you are allowing the HTTP traffic. So if you want to have the traffic allowed for particular one range, like suppose 192.168.1.0 range, so you put that one with the specific suffix like /24 or /16, so that only from the particular address range you will be able to access the HTTP traffic. So let's click on add. So it will add the HTTP traffic. So let's wait for it to get complete, so that then we'll go and add for SSH rules. So now you can see TCP 80 is added. So click on another one. So click add rule. So here we'll be going and using SSH CIDR, same thing, and we'll click on add. So you will be allowing everyone to be able to access the servers or instances inside this security group via SSH. So as you can see, both the rules been added. So like this you can create the rule. So now suppose you want to delete the rule, so you select any particular rule or whatever rules you want to delete, you click on them and you click on delete rule. So it will delete the rule, unnecessary rules inside your security policy. We will also add the rule for HTTPS also, because we added only for HTTP. So let's add for HTTPS. So by this we will have port 22, that's for SSH, port 80 for HTTP, and port 443 for HTTPS been added as a rule inside our security group policy. So let's get it loaded. So as you can see, all the three rules been added. So now we will create a key pair for our project. So let's click on access and security. Now here you can see key pair. So till now we didn't create any key pair, so we'll do create key pair. Also you can, instead of creating key pair, also you can create you can import your existing key pairs, so that's also possible. So let's put as a key one. So let's click on create key pair. So it will ask you to download also this key pair, so be save it in proper location, so that whenever you will be accessing your instance, you have to use that key pair. So you should be automatically able to see this key pair being getting downloaded, so you should save it in a proper location. So I am saving it in my home directory. So you save it and keep it, so it will be useful for you when you will be accessing your instances which are being used with this key pair. So now let's again click on this access and security, just to verify whether that key one is been created properly or not. So you can see, yes, key pair key one is been created. So if you want to delete, you click on delete key pair. You can have multiple key pairs also been created, so there is no restriction that you have to only have one single key pair for your project. So if you are having multiple servers with multiple key pairs, you can have, and then you can assign each server with different key pairs, so that you will give access to different set of people to the different set of servers. So you no need to share the same key pair with every one. So like this you can allocate a floating IP for your project, and then you can create your security group policies for allowing SSH, HTTP and HTTPS traffic. And also like this you can create your SSH key pair, so that you can allocate that SSH key pair to your VM instances in your OpenStack platform, and then using that key pair you can connect your servers. So now we'll see how you can do the similar work from your OpenStack CLI client. So let's first log into our lab session. Let's log into our controller node. So controller example.com. So we have been connected to our controller node. Now what we'll do, we'll source or load the keystone file for user 2, because we want to create similar kind of floating IP, security policies and the key pair for our user 2, and then that will be associated with the project 2. So let's load the key file. So if you don't have this key file been created for user 2 or whatever user you're trying, so create this file first. You can refer the admin file, and there you can change the credentials and then to have it created. So now here we have done. So let's create our floating IP. So OpenStack floating underscore IP create from public network. It should be floating space IP, not underscore. So floating IP create public. So you should be able to see it's been created a floating IP. So let's verify the same thing. OpenStack floating IP list. So you should be able to see how many floating IPs been created. So you can see one floating IP been associated with user 2 for project 2. So if you want to see the project ID and you can verify with your project ID, by that you can understand this for project 2 been created. So like this you create floating IP. Now we will create the security policy and we'll associate same similarly here also SSH and HTTP and HTTPS ports in that security policy to allow the traffic on those ports. So for doing that, let's execute the command OpenStack security group create security 2, that's the name for the security policy, and then --- description web and SSH. So you should be able to see that it's been created a new security policy. So you can see it's been created at the name as sec2. So now we will be allowing HTTP and SSH traffic via the security policy. So for doing that, so command will be OpenStack security group rule create, so protocol TCP, then destination port 443 on the security 2. So you should be able to see that 443 been allowed. So now let's do it for port 80. So that's HTTP port. So it's been allowed, and then let's do it for SSH. So that is port 22. So like this you can create the rules for your security policy. So how you can create? So OpenStack security, then group rule create, then --- protocol TCP. Suppose you are allowing for UDP, in that situation you have to give --- protocol UDP, and then suppose you are doing for DNS, so it will be like --- DHT -- port as a 53, and then you give the security policy name. So like this you can add the rules. So now you can see also that what all security policies have been created. So you do OpenStack security list, group list. So you can see web and SSH. So now you can do OpenStack security group, so, and then you take the ID to just to see what all rules and all are added. So you can see rules are created at what time and what direction, ingress direction, IPv4. So here you can see port range is 22, and then you can see for 443 also you should be able to see port 80, and then port 443 also you should be able to see. So like this you can verify also whatever policy you have, the security group you have created. So you can do like this. Now we will create the key pair. So for that OpenStack key pair list. So let's first list down that key. So there's not created any key pair. So you do create key 2, and then we can save it as a key 2 dot shut. So like this you can create the certificate file. So please remember where you are saving this file, because you need to have this file handy when you will be connecting to the VMs which are using this key file. So you can verify whether you have this file. Yes, key to. So you can SCP or download this file from your controller node and keep it in a safe place so that you can use that to connect your key pairs. So you can verify same thing whether it's been created or not. So go back to your Horizon and log in as user 2 and verify the same thing. So let's go back to our login page. So give me a second. So user 2, so let's log in with user 2. It's been logging in. So here you can see floating IP has been created. One security groups are 2 out of 10 because we have created one floating IP. So for that is showing this thing. So click on is access and security. So I'll be able to see the all the newly created floating IP security groups, and also you can see key pair key 2 what I have created is been listed here. If I go to security group, so I will be able to see the security 2. This is the group I have created. And if I go to the floating IP, I will be able to see the newly created floating IP which I created via OpenStack CLI client. So all are been showing here. So like this you can create your floating IP for your project, then you can create security groups and SSH key pair for your instances, both from your Horizon web portal or from the OpenStack CLI client.